Welcome back to another Evolution video. My name is Fiber, and today we're going through the evolution of Valheim. Valheim is a fairly recent game, developed by Iron Gate, released on the 2nd of February 2021. If you didn't know already, Valheim is about exploring a huge fantasy world inspired by Norse mythology and Viking culture. And if you don't know what Norse mythology is, think of Thor from the Avengers, about where he lives and what his overall storyline is. There are 9 realms in Norse mythology: Niflheim, Muspelheim, Asgard, Midgard, Jotunheim, Vanaheim, Alfheim, Svartalfheim, and Helheim, all held in the branches and roots of the world tree Yggdrasil. Valheim was designed to be a 10th world for the game. You start your adventure at the peaceful center of Valheim. The further you travel from the middle, the more challenging it becomes, ranking up your stats and fighting stronger monsters as you go. The first ever footage of the project that would eventually become Valheim was uploaded back in September 2017 on the personal YouTube channel of the creator of Valheim, Richard Svensson. At this point in time, the game was not called Valheim. Instead, it was called the Swedish name for feud, which is
Fate.
Looking through the old prototype footage, you can clearly see a lot of differences. I mean, look at the main character. Right now, he's just a bunch of shapes. Of course, it's meant to look like this, as it is a prototype and is going to be replaced with an actual character. Same with the Mario Thwomp looking mobs. Although there's quite a few differences, there's also a lot of similarities. The overall map design is pretty similar to what we have today. Forest slash hilly areas, with the exception of it looking more blocky and less realistic, as well as the movement and building concept. It seems as though the creators had a decent idea of which way the game was going at the time, in terms of the base gameplay. Over time, as more time was spent on developing the game, they added more and more different things, such as bows, marshlands, different biomes, and even the first actual mob, with the character design being a big troll. All of this being documented on Richard Svensson's personal YouTube channel. It was during this time that they also decided to implement the idea of Norse mythology. This is where they will base the game's storyline and various different quests off. Eventually, in April 2018, the project officially changed its name to Valheim. It was here that Valheim began to look like a real game, with better shaders and various different creatures, such as the Grey Dwarf Shaman and the Rancid Remains. October 27th, 2019, Valheim creators released footage of a Valheim character sailing a fairly big ship across a vast and hostile ocean. This represents the amount of development that has been going on the game behind the scenes, slowly but surely prepping up for release on February 2nd, 2021. Early Access Steam release. Valheim was finally released for early access on Steam for around $20, and since then has been tearing up the Steam sell charts, being on top of the best sellers list, sitting at an overwhelming positive rating of about 178,000, with just over 3 million downloads in 2 weeks. The developers did anticipate a somewhat successful launch, however, they were not prepared for the huge numbers it came out with. Due to the popularity of the game, the Valheim servers had a lot of server issues, as well as multiple exploits being found within the game. Update 0.142.1 was the first update for Valheim after the early access release. It consisted of many bug fixes, as well as increased texture quality. Most of the updates of Valheim right now aren't game changing. There's not really any point in going through them. The stories and end goals of Valheim have already been set in place, so not many game changing updates will be available for a while. So far, they're just all bug fixes and tweaks towards the game, making the game better right now, but not adding anything to it. But saying that, Valheim has only been released for nearly 2 months. There is so much time for developers to add many different things. Speaking of it, Irongate have already planned out what they're going to add over the next few months to Valheim. The first update that is planned is called Hearth and Home, which is going to focus on the building and cooking in the game by adding different shapes and sizes in the game to make your buildings look more aesthetically pleasing. After update 1, the devs will be focusing more on exploration and combat. In the second update, Cult of the Wolf, we may potentially receive more loot or get new points of interest when we explore, or even get new weapons and armor. In the third update, there'll be more focusing on the sea. In the update, Ships and the Sea, this will increase the current selection of ships that we currently have access to, as well as adding more mobs and loot within the ocean, maybe even a few ocean side quests. Furthermore, the Mistland biomes are announced to receive a few updates in order to expand on it and add mobs to it. Looking at the biome itself, we can tell that we will probably fight a new spider mob. There may even be a new spider boss. Another biome which was not listed in the old map, but was still found in the game, is the Ashlands, which seems to be a lava themed biome with fire everywhere. Is very distant from the center and is considered to be at the very end of the world. It's probably the hell of the game, just like the Nether for Minecraft or the Underworld for Terraria. After these few updates, we will move into phase 2, let's say, called If Odin Wills It. These series of updates will improve the multiplayer side of the game. If done correctly, it does have the potential to become the next big open sandbox game like Minecraft or Terraria. After this, we will get more combat improvement. We will see what they mean by this. It could be new moves when fighting mobs, who knows. We will also see the addition of moon phases. This could potentially be like the Blood Moon in Terraria, where all the mobs in the game have a higher spawn rate and are a lot stronger. I'm not sure what they mean by tar pits. It could mean literal tar pits, probably in the Ashland biome. Additionally, you should save your gold for now, as Haldor, the merchant, is getting an inventory expansion, probably adding a lot more loot to get. We can see that they're also planning on adding Svartalfar brigands. Sorry if I didn't say that right. If we go back and look at Norse mythology, I think they're dark elves who dwell in Svartalfheim, which, as we know, is a whole other world in Norse mythology, meaning this update could bring something huge to the game. By the end of 2021, they will add various new locations and a sandbox mode where you can build as much as you please. Finally, they will add the second of Odin's crows, Munin, the first being Hugin, already in the game. I wonder what Munin's purpose is going to be, or will he just be the same as Hugin? I'm not sure, to be honest. This is all just an outline of what they decide to add. Many other things may be introduced as well. What do you guys think they're going to add? Let me know down in the comment section down below. And while you're at it, you may as well leave a like and share this video with a friend. It helps us out tremendously. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you in another Evolution video.